إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. فالحمد لله الذي نزل الفرقان على عبده ليكون للعالمين نذيرا. فالحمد لله الذي له ملك السماوات والأرض ولم يتخذ ولدا ولم يكن له شريك في الملك وخلق كل شيء فقدره تقديرا. فالحمد لله الذي أنزل على عبده الكتاب ولم يجعل له عوجا قيما لينذر بأسا شديدا من لدن ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجرا حسنا. قال الله تعالى في كتابه الكريم، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. محمد رسول الله والذين معه أشداء على الكفار رحماء بينهم تراهم ركعا سجدا يبتغون فضلا من الله ورضوانا صدق اللہ العلی العظیم. رب اشرح لی صدری ویسر لی امری واحلل عقدۃ من لسانی یفقہوا قولی. اللہم لا سہل الا ما جعلته سہلا وانت تجعل الحزن اذا شئت سہلا. مائی ڈیئر برادرز اینڈ سسٹرز ان اسلام، ان دا سیریز آف فرائیڈے خطبہز وی آر ٹرائنگ ٹو انڈرسٹینڈ the names of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As I said, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that he is given many names by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inna li asma'an, and then he listed the names which he is given. Ana Muhammad, ana Ahmad, he told us, wa ana al-Mahi, وأنا الحاشر وأنا العاقب وأنا المقفى وأنا نبي الرحمة وأنا نبي التوبة. These are the names, the list of names Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told us in a Sahih Hadith. And remember, these are sifati names, attributic names. These names reflect the character, the life of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that he is a source of rahmah. Ana nabiyur rahmah, ana Muhammad, he is the most praiseworthy. Wa ana nabiyut tauba. So these names reflect the character, the seerah, the life of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the features of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's life. And through these names we are actually mentioning the life of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his character, his role in the humanity. So through these names, in the last few khutbas we learnt about Muhammad and Ahmad, that he is the most praiseworthy, al-Mahmud. He will be stationed on the day of judgment at a muqam. He will be given a rank where the whole humanity will praise him, including Muslims and non-Muslim, and that will be a station of al-muqam, al-mahmud. And today we are trying to grasp and understand another name, which is again he mentioned in the same hadith, wa anal hashir, I am hashir. This name is from hashir, resurrection, the day of judgment. This is one of the name of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as he told us, wa anal hashir. And then he gave a little bit explanation of this name in the hadith, alladhi yahshuru an-nasu ala qadami. He explained that this means the hashir, the day of judgment, the day of resurrection, will occur at my feet. And scholars gave different explanations what Prophet ﷺ exactly meant when he said that Hashar will occur, day of resurrection will occur at my feet. الَّذِي يَحْشُرُ النَّاسُ عَلَىٰ قَدَمِي. There are different explanations which are found in the books of Ahadith. One of the explanation is that when Prophet ﷺ said, وَأَنَا الْحَاشِرُ الَّذِي يَحْشُرُ النَّاسُ عَلَىٰ قَدَمِي, that the day of my name is Hashir, and my the day of resurrection, the day of Hashir, will occur right at my feet, at my feet. It means that the day of judgment will be soon after Prophet's passing away. Prophet passed away, he came. He came to this world as the last prophet, and there is no prophet after him. When he said that Hashar is at my feet, this he meant that there is no Nabi after me, I am the last prophet. And between me and the Hashar, there is not going to be any more prophet. There is not going to be any series of prophet anymore. So this means that I am nearer the time of the Hashar because no prophet is to come anymore. And you might ask that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away 1400 years ago. It's about 1.5 centuries. The day of judgment still did not come. It still didn't occur. The answer we can find in the Quran and Hadith is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in Surah Ma'arij that these days of ours are not equal to the days of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created this world in 7 days, Allah's days are bigger. A lot bigger than our days. This worldly life, the days of this life, the years of this life are very, very short and fake. There is no barakah in these days. Allah's days, as He tells us in the Quran, كَانَ مِنْ قَدَارُهُ 50,000 years. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, the day of resurrection will be as long as 50,000 years of this life. So this is the day of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the language of Allah, Quran and Hadith, it's maybe just 1.5 days. It's not 50,000 years. It's only 1 century. It's around 1400 years so far. Allah's day is 50,000 years. And also, if we compare the time period after Prophet ﷺ passed away till so far, if we compare this time period with the time period Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala since created this world, it's nothing. So, when Prophet ﷺ said that I am very near to the day of judgment, actually in one of the hadith, Prophet ﷺ showed his two fingers joined together, his middle finger and his forefinger. He joined these two fingers together and he said, the day of judgment and my arrival is as close as these two fingers. I am sent, I am the first sign of the day of judgment. There are so many ahadiths which it signifies this. Prophet ﷺ said, I am the first, my arrival is the first sign of the day of judgment. My arrival means that day of judgment is not very far anymore. So, this is one of the explanation al-Hashir when Prophet ﷺ said, الَّذِي يَحْشُرُ النَّاسُ عَلَىٰ قَدَمِي. And also, Hashir also mean, Hashir mean together. Hashratul Ard. Hashir mean gathering. And Hashir, ala wazni fa'il, Hashir, fa'il, which means that the one who gathers people, the one who leads people, he is the leader. This also mean, al-Hashir mean, he is the leader of humanity. And he's the best human being. He's the best leader. He is the only leader. Although he came in the series of prophets in the end, but he is the most senior prophet. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us in one of the hadiths, Ana sayyidu waladi Adam, wala fakhr. And he said, I am the best human being in all the children of Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. And I am not saying this out of pride. He meant that it's not the pride I am showing. This is the reality. This is the truth which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed me with this rank. I'm not saying this just to show off. Wala fakhr. Ana sayyidu waladi Adam. Wala fakhr. And I'm not saying this out of pride. This is not show off. So this is Hal Hashir, means the leader who will gather people. And really, in one of the last khutbah, we learned that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam on the day of resurrection, the whole humanity will approach him as a leader. We learned that, we mentioned this in the hadith, that people on the day of judgment, they will approach Adam alayhi salatu wasalam for help. That you go to Allah and speak to him that the day of judgment should begin. Adam alayhi salatu wasalam will not be able to help. Then the people will go to Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, then Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, then Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, that in the end they will go to for help. They will go to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he will say, Ana laha, this is my job. I will lead you. I will speak. I will represent you on the day of judgment. I will represent you in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is Hashir. This is the leadership, the whole humanity. Because he will agree to lead people, to speak to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will station him at Al-Maqam Al-Mahmood, where he will beg and plead to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on behalf of the whole humanity. He will represent the whole humanity, Muslims, non-Muslims, because he will be representing the whole humanity to communicate with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is going to be kind of helping people on the day of judgment, leading people. So that is why he is Al-Hashir. He is the leader. He is Sayyid. He is Al-Hashir. So this is another explanation we find then when Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, An Al-Hashir. I am Al-Hashir. And another explanation we see that the day of judgment is not very far after Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And when we say that after Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, apparently it's many hundred years has passed. And we see this, that as compared to the days of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our years are not very long. Even we see this in our observation, because when you ask someone who is 90 year old, 60 year old, 50 year old, he will say, my 50 years of age has passed just like blink of an eyes. I just remember as if I was just, it was just yesterday when I was 5 year old, 6 year old, and I was in a primary school, and I was in a high school. It looks like yesterday I was young, I was teenage. So my 50 year, my 60 year, even if you ask somebody who is 100 year old, even he will say, 100 years apparently is a long period. But he will say, I don't know. The life passed so quickly. So the days of this life, the years of this life, the months of this life, we observe and we feel when we see our age, when we see the years of our age, we realize it's not very long life. It's very short life. The days, the time, they are very, very short. So that is why Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Although it looks many hundred years, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Wa ana al hashir alladhi yahshuru an-nas ala qadami." Hashar will be at my feet. So hashar will be soon after me. It's not going to be very long. My arrival is one of the signs of the day of judgment. There are so many signs of the day of judgment. The arrival of Dajjal and Imam Mahdi and Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, big sign, Yajuj Majuj, which are mentioned in the Quran. There are so many signs. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, the arrival of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam is the first sign of the day of Hashr. That is why he said, "Wa ana al-Hashir." In the last khutbas, we learned about Muhammad and Ahmad and al-Muqam al-Mahmud. And here we are learning about Al-Hashir. This is one of the name of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And through these names, sifati names, we are trying to learn. We are trying to reflect upon the character, about the life, about the uswa, about the maqam of our Nabi Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And similarly, another example we see in the Quran about the length of this life and the length of these years. This is mentioned, reflected in Surah Baqarah, in Surah Ali Imran, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about Uzair alayhi salatu wasalam. He mentioned that he was passing through an area, and the people, the area, it was like destroyed through sometimes the flood comes, sometimes the earthquake, the whole city is destroyed. He was passing through some city, and he noticed the ruins of that city, the destroyed city. The whole city was collapsed on its roofs, all the houses, and he was looking at it. This is mentioned in Surah Baqarah in ayah number 259. أَوْ كَالَّذِي مَرَّ عَلَىٰ قَرْيَةٍ وَهِيَ خَاوِيَةٌ عَلَىٰ عُرُوشِيَا. So that's how we give the example when a person was passing through عَلَىٰ قَرْيَةٌ, a قَرْيَةٌ, a city, وَهِيَ خَاوِيَةٌ عَلَىٰ عُرُوشِيَا, whose roofs was collapsed on its, the whole city was collapsed upside down. And then he questioned, then the question came in his mind, قَالَ أَنَّا يُحْيِي هَذِهِ اللَّهُ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهَا. O Allah, the whole city is destroyed. There's no sign of life in this city. How will you resurrect? How will you do Hashr? How will you give them life again, this city, this the whole people, the whole humanity? قَالَ أَنَّا يُحْيِي هَذِهِ اللَّهُ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهَا. And in response to this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him death straight away. Uzair alayhi salatu wasalam. فَأَمَاتَهُ اللَّهُ. We made him dead. مِئَةَ عَامٍ, for 100 years. ثُمَّ بَعْثَ. Then we resurrected him. And then we asked him, after 100 years of death, قَالَ كَمْ لَبِثْتَ. How many years have you been dead or asleep? قَالَ كَمْ لَبِثْتَ. He said, قَالَ لَبِثْتُ يَوْمًا أَوْ بَعْدَ يَوْمٍ. I've been dead, I've been asleep maybe a day or part of the day. يَوْمًا أَوْ بَعْدَ يَوْمٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, قَالَ بَلْ لَبِثْتَ مِئَةَ عَامٍ. You have been dead for 100 years. You see, 100 years and 1,000 years of this life, they look like a day or so. So this is what we reflect from the name of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Al-Hashir, that he is Al-Hashir. The day of judgment is not very far. And another explanation we see, by scholars that when Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said wa anal hashir, he meant that he will be, because again this is explained from other ahadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because he said in another hadith that I will be the first one who will be resurrected on the day of judgment. That's what al-hashir means. You know when people will be resurrected again? When the trumpet will be blown, when the sur will be blown, and the people will be resurrected, they will be made alive, they will be made alive, the life will be given to them, resurrection, hashir. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will be the first one who will stand up and will be given a life after the blowing of the trumpet, second trumpet. As we see in the Quran, the first trumpet will be blown, the whole humanity living, all the living creatures will be dead, and the second trumpet will be blown. Then the whole humanity and all the living creatures will be made alive. She'll stand up again. وَنُفِخَ فِي السُّورِ. We learn this in Surah Zumar. وَنُفِخَ فِي السُّورِ. When the trumpet will be blown. فَسَعِكَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ. Everything in this earth, everything in this earth will become unconscious, faint, will become dead. وَنُفِخَ فِي السُّورِ فَسَعِكَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا مَنْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ نُفِخَ فِيهِ أُخْرَى. When the second trumpet again will be blown, ثُمَّ نُفِخَ فِيهِ أُخْرَى فَإِذَا هُمْ قِيَامٌ. Everybody will stand up. قِيَامٌ يَنْظُرُونَ. They will be looking around. Panic. What has happened? You know, somebody who has been in grave for thousand and thousand centuries and years, and he is given a life. Imagine, he is blinking an eyes, his bones and everything is given flesh again. He is a living person again from the grave, and he is coming out of the grave, and he is looking around, where am I? Just like, you know, when we go to sleep, when we wake up in the morning from our sleep, on our bed, the first few seconds we realize where we are. Am I on my bed? Maybe we are still in the journey of our dream. Maybe we are seeing the dream and we are awakened. For a few seconds we don't know where we are. We look around astonishingly on the walls. After a few seconds, we realize, oh, it was just a dream. And I'm on my bed. I'm not anywhere else. So that's how, after a few seconds, we realize where we are. Few seconds, we just panicking, rubbing our eyes, trying to work out what has happened, where we are. Similarly, when the second trumpet will be blown, people will be resurrected from their death, from their graves. People will come out from their graves. And for many minutes or for a long period of time, they won't even know what has happened, where we are. Because many people lived a life not believing on the day of resurrection. So they didn't expect it. They didn't expect it. So when they actually come out of the grave and they see themselves alive, it will be like astonishing to them. They will take something they never believed in. They will find it something very, very unexpected. So it will be very, very panicking to them. They will say, those people, the non-believers, when they will come out of the grave, they will say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah Yasin, قَالُوا يَا وَيْلَنَا مَنْ بَعَثَنَا مِنْ مَرْقَدِنَا. Woe, who has awakened us up from our graves? Hada ma vada Rahman. Then after a while they will say, oh, this is the day of judgment, which we used to deny. It actually has happened. قَالُوا يَا وَيْلَنَا مَنْ بَعَثَنَا مِنْ مَرْقَدِنَا هَذَا مَا وَعَدَ الرَّحْمَنِ وَصَدَقَ الْمُرْسَلُونَ This means the messengers, they used to tell the truth. It was true that the day of judgment was going to occur. So this is many people, when they will come out of their graves after the second trumpet, they won't even realize that this is the day of, they won't even know that this is the day of judgment. Everybody will come to know the reality, the day of judgment occurrence, based how much he had a belief on it. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in one of his hadiths that I will be the first one who will realize, who will know that yes, this is the day of judgment. His iman, his faith. So that is why he is called Alladhi yahshuru an-nasu ala qadami. That day of judgment will occur at my feet. Day of judgment will occur at my feet. So I will be the first one, Anal Hashir. I will be the first one who will realize that this is the day of Hashir. This is the day of judgment. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in one of the hadith that my grave will be the first grave who will open apart and I will come out of it. So Prophet's grave in Medina, this is going to be the first grave which will open apart and Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will come out of it. So this is the little bit explanation of another name of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he said wa anal hashir. And through this name, through this Safati name, we have learnt some more features and characteristics points about the uswa of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq and take him sallallahu alaihi wasallam as our role model in our life. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم